What's up, everyone? Today we're going to be making an Instant Pot Bolognese. This will be a tofu version, and this recipe was inspired by Rainbow Plant Life, Nisha Vora. I have all the ingredients in front of me, and this is one of my favorite dishes to make, but let's go through all the ingredients one by one. Let's start with the main ingredients. I have 1 pound of penne pasta. This is a whole foods version, but you're free to use any kind of pasta you want. 1 block of firm tofu. We have 1 medium yellow onion, a bunch of celery, and those are the main ingredients. Now, for the seasonings, we have chili powder, Italian seasonings. You can also use like the individual Italian seasonings in here. This already has oregano, marjoram, thyme, basil, sage, and rosemary already in it. Garlic powder. This is a crushed red pepper. We got salt and pepper. An entire jar of marinara sauce. I'm using Newman's own. And a can of diced tomatoes. We have 32 ounces of vegetable broth and extra virgin olive oil. But let's get started. This will be a cooking from scratch. I won't skip any steps. So let's get these rubber trivets out, place our cutting board down. We don't want it to move around. You could also use a wet paper towel, but I find this is the least messiest way to do it. And the most time consuming part now, we have to press the water out of this tofu for at least half an hour. So I'm gonna take some paper towel here, put it down on the cutting board, and we're gonna press this tofu. Let me open the package. And we'll wash this tofu and then start pressing the water out. All right, now that this tofu is rinsed, now we need to put it on the cutting board like that and get another piece of paper towel, put it on top. Now we're going to press the water out. I do this by getting a frying pan, putting it on top, and getting some cans. And now we wait. I'll see you in half an hour. All right, it's been half an hour. Let's take the frying pan and these cans of beans off, and the tofu will be ready to use. One thing I forgot to include in the ingredients, a package of mushrooms. You can use any kind of mushrooms you want. I like the white mushrooms. So as you can see, most of the water is gone now. My cutting block is all wet. All right, so now I need to get my Instant Pot out. Let's open the lid and I'll put it over here. I'll plug it in. All right, so I'm just going to transfer all my seasonings over there to the stove so you can see it. Of course, you have to season the tofu to your taste, so adjust accordingly. So what you want to do here is hit the saute button. We're going to let this warm up for a bit until it says hot. And then I'm going to pour some olive oil in the Instant Pot and crumble in the tofu with your hands. All right, let's wait for the Instant Pot to warm up. Get my olive oil. Can't forget this. And I have a spatula to stir the tofu around. I try not to use like a half of a teaspoon of any kind of seasoning at a time. To wait until it reads hot, and then I'll pour the olive oil in. This is a pretty hands-off recipe once we start adding the vegetables and the pasta and the sauce. We still have to cut up the vegetables and the ingredients once we are done with the tofu. All right, it's reading hot. Let me switch the angle. I guess that'll work. We'll add about a tablespoon of olive oil. Oh, that's a lot of olive oil, but that'll work. Spread around a little bit. Well, I don't have to worry about the tofu sticking to the bottom of the Instant Pot now with this much olive oil in there. All right, so now I have my block of tofu. We're gonna take the whole thing and just crumble it in with two hands, like so. Just do this. This will be our protein. If you don't want tofu, you could always substitute another ingredient like chicken or beef. And the tofu that's too big in the Instant Pot, we'll just grind them up with the spatula. Just make it as small as you can. Okay, let me wash my hands and we'll add all the seasonings. Okay, let's brush this up a little bit. All right, some seasonings now. Let's add the Italian seasoning, which is basically like basil, oregano, thyme, sage, and rosemary. Should be enough. Add some black pepper. Can find the opening to this thing. Some salt. You don't need that much salt. Some chili powder. Garlic powder. And my garlic powder doesn't want to come out. Gotta use a spoon. Yeah, that should be enough. Garlic powder became very hard. I haven't used it in a while. So, and the crushed red pepper. Right, now we saute this for about 4 to 5 minutes until the tofu gets brown. Mix up all the seasonings. Let it mix in with the olive oil as well. Parts of the tofu that I didn't put are on the bottom before I add the seasonings are already starting to get turn color and turn brown. All right, we'll just let it sit here.
another 2 minutes or so, it should be ready. And then we gotta remove the tofu from the Instant Pot. So alright, it's ready to be removed from the Instant Pot now. Let's hit the cancel button to stop the sauteing, and we'll remove all this tofu and put it to the side. We'll add these back in after we're done chopping our vegetables. You can't get every little bit of tofu left from the Instant Pot, because it's going to be put right back in anyway. This is just to stop it from cooking. All right, if you see like what I have here, there's a little bit of burnt bits here. We don't want that in the Instant Pot, or else when we start to pressure cook it, it will stop the pressure cooking and say burnt food, or say burn. So in order to get rid of all these scraps, we have to add some more olive oil to break it up. That should be enough. Now. All right, so got the tofu on the side, and now let's deal with all these vegetables. So we're gonna have to wash all of these now before we start cutting them. Let's do that. Let's start with the onion. Celery. Actually, the celery is a little bit old. I had it in the fridge for about a week. So after this, I'm probably going to throw it out. But I'm going to use 3 stalks of celery here. Yeah, maybe 4. I might as well use it up. Yeah, let's go with 5. This is a thin one. And this I'm not going to use anymore. But we'll wash all the celery.
mushrooms. Let me get a... this thing here. It's like dirt in here too. We'll get rid of the bigger dirt pieces. Because there's dirt in here, you definitely need to wash these mushrooms. Don't want to be eating dirt. Okay, so these mushrooms are washed now. Let me get out my chef's knife. And we'll start to cut up this food. Let me cut the end of the celery so we don't need these. And also the tops. I know these aren't the greenest stalks of celery, but I don't want to get sick eating. Ooh, that's starting to spoil a little bit. Okay, we have our celery. Let's cut up this onion. Hope I don't fry. It's probably gonna happen. All right, let me remove the onion skin now. It's easier to do once you cut the onion in half. Okay, this is done. Now the other half. All right, let's cut up this onion now. Doesn't really matter which way you cut it because we're gonna make them smaller anyway and get really small cuts. Wash this onion that we got on the floor. And we'll cut off the end here. Don't want to eat that. And this end as well. So let's try to cut this up some more. All Okay, now I have my celery and onions cut up. We're gonna put this on the side and we gotta cut up the mushrooms. Okay, now for our mushrooms. I didn't cry when cutting up those onions, by the way. I feel a tear coming, but I didn't have a full-fledged crying situation there. Actually, these mushrooms are a few days old already. I should have cooked this earlier. But I'm glad I'm getting around to it now. Alright, so everything's all cut up now. Now we gotta go back to our Instant Pot right here. And I already added my tablespoon of olive oil. I could put some more in. Cook the vegetables now. Let's hit the saute button. Break up a lot of these burnt pieces at the bottom of the Instant Pot. Okay. Let's start adding all our vegetables now. These vegetables will really go down once they start cooking. We just put them in here and stir them around for a little bit and wait about 5 minutes so they soften up, and you'll see the
vegetables go down. Another piece of onion. If you want, at this point, you could add some more salt and pepper. Maybe I'll add a little bit more salt. Vegetables began to soften up already. Okay, here's my cooked tofu. I'm gonna put it in. It's been 5 minutes. cancel button on the Instant Pot. And now the fun part, we add everything in and start the pressure cooking. We can add the entire package of penne because this is exactly 1 pound. Order because since it'll be sitting here in the Instant Pot, we won't be able to stir it. So let's push down this penne. Now we add the vegetable broth. We want the whole 32 ounces of vegetable broth in there. We want to pour the penne into the vegetable broth so that the liquid covers it and we can properly cook this. Okay, I think that's good. Now we add the marinara sauce. Entire jar of marinara sauce. To add the diced tomatoes, I'm actually going to rinse off the top and drain the excess water after I open it with the can opener. So I'm not going to open up the diced tomatoes can the entire way so I could push down on the lid and pour the water out. All right, so we want to, let's take this out. I don't need this anymore. We just want to put these diced tomatoes on top and not stir it in. That way it keeps the consistency. Afterwards, we can stir it when it's done. And there it goes. We're ready to start cooking it. Get our lid. Make sure the knob is set to sealing so it properly gets the pressure. And we want to pressure cook this for 5 minutes on high. So it's right now on low. I got a pressure level, high pressure. And we'll wait for it to cook. And while that is going on, I'm going to clean up the kitchen.
this is that you just set the Instant Pot and forget it, and you can start cleaning up. Thank you.
takes a while for it to get to pressure, but once it gets going, it will be quick.
right, so 5 minutes from now, the meal should be ready. Let me get my plate out. And also the spoon. Let's move this a little closer. You can hear the pasta just cooking in there, bubbling up. All right, it's done cooking. Let's release the pressure. Don't want to be touching this knob with your hands. So I'm going to do it with the spoon here. But watch all the steam come out. Don't want to try to force this lid open before the pressure gets to room level. We'll know when that's ready when the floating valve goes down. Still a good amount of pressure in there. All right, it's ready to open. And it is ready. Let's stir this up and serve it. This pasta is cooked perfectly. And here is the finished dish. Instant pot bolognese with tofu. Time to eat this. Still hot. Might have to wait a little bit. Delicious. This pasta's al dente. Marinara sauce gives it a lot of flavor. Tofu, Italian seasonings. Excellent. Give this recipe a try. Let me know what you think. If you enjoy this, hit the like button, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye.